Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and I am back with another video on Terraform. In this video, we are going to learn how to install Terraform, how to integrate Consul service with Terraform, how to create and store AWS client and secret key in Consul for Terraform. Terraform will read those keys from Consul and write VM's name, public IP and ID to HashiCorp console service. Then we are going to write .tf files and finally creating, deleting EC2 VMs with Terraform. So let's begin. Before completing this exercise, you required HashiCorp console service up and running at your end. If you need any assistant on this, you can watch the video on my YouTube channel. In this video, I explained in details how to install and configure HashiCorp Consul service along with create and store key value service for AWS access and secret key. Once your Consul service is up and running, come back to this exercise. I am ready with the Consul service and access and secret key has been created for AWS. I am going to use Ubuntu machine for this demonstration. I am going to download the Terraform executable from HashiCorp. Terraform zip file has been downloaded. Let me unzip it. This is the only executable file we require for Terraform. Let's move this executable file. Let's copy this executable in user bin folder and now verify the installation. Yes, it is working fine. Let's create a separate directory for the AWS. I assume that you have the basic knowledge on Terraform, so I am not explaining the basic concept of Terraform in this video. So I'm directly creating two files. One is main.tf file. Second is variable.tf file to manage AWS infrastructure. I recommended to use Visual Studio to writing Terraform files and template because these Terraform files and templates are written down into HCL, HashiCorp language. And if you look at in left hand side, I search HCL and many plugins or extensions are available. I installed the required one to support HCL language. I am coming back to main.tf file and this file starts with provider called Consul. To access resources on Consul cluster, we are providing the address of Consul cluster where it can be accessible. We also providing a data center name. In this demonstration, we are creating EC2 instance on AWS and to access the resources on AWS, we required AWS access and secret key. You can provide these information in Terraform template or you can store these information in variable file on the server. In both situation, sensitive information are stored in plain text on server and it is accessible by everyone. To avoid this situation, we are storing the AWS access and secret key on console cluster and Terraform will read these information from the console cluster. Let's see how. Terraform will use console underscore keys to read the values from console cluster. So we are reading data from the console cluster and this is the name of this resource. First we are reading the value of key called size and the location or path will be AWS size. If there is no value in console key store, then default value will be t2.micro. Let's look at the console cluster. This is my console cluster and I am looking at my key value. Click on AWS. At this moment, I don't have any key name called size. Let's create one. And value will be save it. So I do have now key size. Next key, we are looking for access key. I already created key for the access key and key for secret key. So Terraform will read value of size, access and secret key directly from console cluster to access the resources on AWS. Next, we are using AWS provider and it is required minimum three attributes. First one is access key, and we do lookup on console key value called data, console underscore key name and variable access key. Similarly, we do lookup for secret key, and third one is region, and we are getting this input from the variable files. This is the variable file you are going to create it, and I created a variable called AWS underscore region. This is the default value of this variable. So look at here, we are doing lookup on variable dot AWS region and it is giving back this value. Once the provider set, then we are calling the resources on AWS, and AWS underscore instance is one of the resource in AWS to create EC2 instance. This is the name of this resource. It should be unique in your Terraform template. And we are getting the value for AMI from the combination of two variables. These two variables are located in variable file AWS underscore AMIS. And these are AMI number for AWS machine. And this is the location. If this particular AMI is not available on this region, then AMI value will be null. We are getting the instance type input from console key value store, and we are providing the tag to the EC2 instance. By using this information, Terraform will create a EC2 instance on the AWS infrastructure. We are not using the console service to read key value store, but also we are using it to write key value store. We are using the console underscore keys resource, and this is the name. We are writing down three keys. First one is instance ID, and value is coming from newly created instance. We are also using true value for delete attribute. It means that when you destroy the resource with the Terraform, these keys are also deleted from console key value store. Second key we are going to create or store called public DNS, and value will be public DNS of newly created EC2 instance. And finally, name or tag of newly created EC2 instance. Let's upload both the file on the demo server. Both the file has been created on AWS folder. First, we start with Terraform initialization command. Initialization command basically download all the required providers, dependencies or plugins. So do Terraform init. It is checking the plugins. It is required the plugins called console, then downloading AWS. Terraform has been successfully initialized. Now let's do a validation on these files. Looks okay. Let's do Terraform apply or create EC2 instance. It is asking for a confirmation. Say yes. AWS instance is creating. It has completed. Let's verify on AWS console. Our EC2 instance is successfully up and running on AWS. Let's verify the key store value in console cluster. Let's click on key value tab and click on AWS. it created three key value for you. Click on ID, and this is your EC2 instance ID. Let's compare it. This is the instance ID, and it is same instance ID. Click on name and compare it with tag. It is same. And finally, public DNS. And this is public DNS of EC2 instance. And it is same value. By using the console key value store, you can manage and maintain the inventory. And these values are creating and deleting automatically with Terraform action. Now let's go ahead and destroy this instance with Terraform. The command is Terraform destroy. You can see the message. Terraform will perform the following action. It is going to terminate or delete this AWS instance, as well as it is going to delete the key value store. Give the confirmation, say yes. It has been completed. Let's verify. Yes, it has been terminated from the AWS. Let's verify the console service. Yes, it has been deleted the reference of EC2 instance. So this is the complete demonstration how you can use the console service in Terraform. You can download main.tf and variable.tf file from my GitHub account. You can read more about the console data source from the HashiCorp website. I will give the link in the description. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.